What's up, Carlos?
I'm taking.
I'm Kia. Today's lunch is nachos. Tomorrow's lunch is chicken tenders, two-piece with garlic toast. We are kicking off the Red Zone with some news from last week, the Powerpuff game. The Saints got first, the Vikings got second, the Packers got third, the Bears got fourth. We will show you some of the highlights.
And my question for y'all is, what y'all thoughts for tonight? How y'all think it's gonna go?
It's gonna go great. It's gonna go our girls' way. Saints will be home.
It's gonna go perfect. Our girls are ready and they're ready to dominate.
I like those answers.
Emerson.
Cody. Yeah. And my question for y'all is, how y'all think tonight gonna go?
Great.
Alright.
Alright, I need appreciate it.
Starving Children volunteers on Tuesday, October 15th. They are looking for 18-year-olds or older who can drive. The address will be located on the screen. Now for some CTN sports highlights.
Highlights are here, so let's rip through them. A high five for you, a headbutt for you, and more high fives all around. Celebrate a scoop and score. Sports Night is next.
Last week was homecoming for the Cardinals, and they hosted one of the best teams in the state. Maple Grove came in undefeated, scoring more than 40 points per game while giving up less than 10. And believe it or not, Cardinals actually won the second half. Crimson were cruising by that point, though, because they were dominant from the start. This is the first play from scrimmage. Little screen pass to the fullback, Jeffrey Nordvold. He's got blockers in front of him. He picks up 42 yards. Maple Grove is in the red zone. Two plays later, they're in the end zone. James Engel takes the pitch left side, scores from the 13. Crimson on the board just over 2 minutes into the game. After a Cardinals three and out, Maple Grove marches down, and Engel gets his second score of the night in easily from the two-yard line. Cardinals didn't have a first down in the first quarter, and the Crimson offense was rolling. Caden Harney connected with Nathan Romadka for two scores in the first quarter. First from 21 yards, then this one from 48. Maple Grove recovered a fumble for a touchdown on the final play of the quarter and was up 35-0. Cardinals get their first down early in the second. Nice look from Murtessa Muhammad to Braden Waldron. Goes for 31 yards into Crimson territory, but the very next play, Jeremy Addy, in a bunch of white jerseys, they pry it free. It was 49-0 at the half. But the Cardinals, they had two takeaways in the third quarter. That young man right there had the first fumble forced and recovered, then recovered the second and returned it 60 yards for the score. And then they get the touchdown from Joitsa on the run, their first rushing touchdown of the season. So yes, Howie, as you mentioned, 14-7 in that second half. Tennis team wrapped up its team schedule with a loss in the second round of the section tournament on Tuesday last week, losing to Buffalo by a 7-0 score. They tried to stack the doubles lineup, hoping it would work out in their favor, and they did have a couple of those go to three sets. Newton and Easton teamed up at first doubles. Anderson and Smensky then dropped down to second doubles. They lost in a tiebreak, 10-8. The combo of Ruddy and Lee at third doubles also kept close, but singles was pretty one-sided for Buffalo. The Cardinals had lost to them, I think, 5-2 early in the season, so they were hoping to show something, but also toying with that lineup, and that's what's left. I think Wayzata actually has already won that game earlier today, so they are in awaiting the winner of Maple Grove and Delano.
The Bengals were a couple of games under 500, but they are having more frequent success, including six of their previous seven. So they would be a formidable foe, no question.
Coach Ashley Raddus would rather have it now than come section time, but it certainly didn't help last week against Andover. Huskies finished third in sections last year, and while they lost a lot, they still clearly have a lot of talent and plenty of. Well, the soccer teams are entering the section tournament this week with first round scheduled on Tuesday. Last week, wrapping up the regular season, the boys on the road for both of their contests last week. On Monday at Park Center, they lose to the Pirates by a 2-0 score.
Well, the Cardinals' final game of the regular season took them to Champlin Park on Wednesday. The Rebels had just six wins, but they were 3-1-1 over their previous five, so they were clearly playing their best soccer of the year. The Cards, meanwhile, were trying to end a five-game winless streak.
Girls soccer team we talked about last week had their first win of the year over St. Paul Johnson, putting up 13 goals. Well, they follow that with their second win of the year and a shutout.
6 goals.
No less against a conference opponent. 6-0 over Park Center. 6 different goal scorers for the Cardinals. That's, think of that. Now you have 19 goals in 2 games, 11 goal scorers in the first game, 6 goal scorers in the second game. So spreading it around, it's awesome. Sophia Bakri and Brianna Wold each added an assist. Errolyn Yang Nguyen, Bailey Rao, Addie Erickson, and Jenna Erickson, the other goal scorers for. So our next event will be on Thursday night. Cardinal football taking on the Blaine Bengals. And then absent a win and a possible semifinal opportunity, as we just talked about, we'll have the football team's final regular season game at home against Farmington on the 17th. And it's volleyball playoffs and football playoffs after that. But that will do it for this edition of CTN Sports Night. We want to thank everybody out there for joining us and continuing to support everything we do here at CTN. To the entire crew, including Howie Shapiro, I'm Joe Young, saying goodnight.
It is time for the weekly calendar. Today is Mental Health Day. Take some time to yourself, help someone else. Everything brings awareness to this under-talked issue. Tonight, October 10th, the Coon Rapids High School, the Coon Rapids Marching Band is hosting their third annual community night in Coon Rapids High School Stadium. Come and celebrate an amazing season and help send the marching band off to their Saturday competition at the Youth and Music Marching Band Grand Championship Stadium. Gates will open for guests at 6:30 p.m. We'll have 2 food trucks at the event, Pigs Unlimited and Unbreakable. Our performances will begin at 7:30 p.m. If you arrive before 7:30 p.m., you are welcome to sit in the bleachers and watch our rehearsal. Re-entry is free. We'll see y'all tomorrow. Thank y'all for watching.